If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, I am Rob, welcome back to my channel. I'm very glad that you guys enjoyed watching the last video, which was the Magic Money Printer. And since you guys like magic, I have decided to make another magical DIY. So today we are making a magical never-ending card. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So first I'm gonna take this square sheet of paper, which is 6 inches by 6 inches. And I have divided this into two equal halves. So this is 3 inches by 6 inches. We need 8 similar pieces. So there you go. We have 8 3 by 6 inches strips of paper. And now I'll show you how you need to fold them to make our magical never-ending card. So we'll take one and we'll fold it in half. Now I will divide this in half again, but this time horizontally. So you can see we divided this in half, first vertically, now horizontally. So we have this cross or plus sign. Now we'll take the top half and divide it in half again. Like that. And the same thing we'll do for the bottom half. And when I open it, you can see that we have divided this into 8 equal parts, and we have to do the same thing for all the pieces. So let's do that, and we are done. So now the easy part is done. Now is the tricky bit, so you have to now watch carefully. I'll show you how you need to stick these pieces together to get a never-ending card. So first I am going to take two of these pieces and I'll align them to form a square, and now I'll take a glue stick and I'll apply glue to the 4 corners right here. In this case, we have these squares, so we'll apply glue on each of this corner square, and then we'll place 2 more strips on top of it, but this time horizontally like this, and stick them in place. Okay, now we'll take 2 strips and we have to stick them horizontally like this. And because we have these tiny squares, we can match them up. So you match the corners like this, match the corners here, align them, press them down and stick. I'll take the other one and place it on top like this, align the corners and stick it in place. Okay, so we are done with our first layer. Now what we need to do is, along this horizontal cut, we will open it like this, flip it, fold it and press it down, form a nice crease, and do the same thing for the bottom flap. Now you can see you have this folded bit right in the middle. So this time when you're applying glue, you have to apply glue to the 4 corners, these tiny squares in the corners, and also this whole middle folded section. So let's apply glue on the corners first. Okay, so now we'll stick 2 more pieces. Again, we will place them vertical like this. Take another one, align it, and then press it down. And we are done with 6 of our pieces. And because these 2 pieces were vertical, now we have a cut in the middle. So we'll open the flaps like this, outwards, the right one, press it down, get a nice crease, open it again. This time the left one, press it down and get a nice crease. Okay, so after you are done opening the flaps, now is the easy bit. You have to apply glue on the whole thing. So I'll start from one corner and gently move upwards, applying glue to each section, each of these tiny square, and then stick the last 2 pieces on it. And these last 2 pieces will stick horizontally. Okay, we are done with our never-ending card. I'll show you how it appears to be never ending. Watch, if you open one flap, you can see one side of the card. You can open another flap and you'll see another side. Open again. And if you keep doing that, it opens and closes like this. And there you go. You have a never-ending card. Now you can make anything on this, anything you want. I like making characters on it, so I'll show you how you can draw some funny characters on your never-ending card. So if you want to make characters on the card, you have to keep in mind that the face should be divided into two halves. So half of the face, like the eyes and the head, should be on one half of this card. And the lower half, which is the mouth, chin, should be on the lower part of the card. And then when you open it, you'll draw the other half of other character. And that's how it'll appear to be never ending. I'll show you how. So first we draw an oval shape. Give him a funky hairdo. Now let's make the nose. Make sure nose is also divided in both the halves. Like that. Now you can make funny mouth, eyes, eyebrows, and you have a funny face, just like that. Now you can open one of the halves like this. So you can see now you have only half of the face. So you can complete it and draw a new character on this one. So as you can see, I'm just connecting the face here and drawing a new half. So you can draw a different set of eyes like this, different eyebrows to make the face look different. Give him a different hairdo, like that. And when you're done with the top half, you can turn the flap and move to the bottom half. So you can see I am making the ears slightly big and making them look different. Even the nose, you can give him a big nose, like this, a little twirly, and maybe make him smile with some funny teeth, like that. Give him a skinny neck, there you go. That's our second character. Now we'll open one of the flaps like this. And similarly, you can keep drawing the characters, flipping and drawing the halves to create a completely new and funny looking character. Okay, so we are done with all the characters. As you can see. So now we will use a marker and we will outline all the pencil lines and color it and see how a never-ending card looks. Go. You have a never-ending card. I hope you guys found this tutorial easy and helpful. Guys, I encourage you to try this out. It's really simple and looks magical. How the card keeps folding and unfolding, and it looks like it's never ending. So you can experiment with characters like these, like we just made, or send someone a personal message or wishes. Imagine they keep folding the card and unfolding it, and the wishes keep coming back again and again. So in a simple way, you're wishing them multiple times. Isn't that awesome? So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a big thumbs up and also let me know in the comments below. You can also connect with me on my Instagram or Facebook page. That's it for this video. I'll see you in my next one with another fun DIY. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.